When has a gut feeling saved your life? Lump in my right breast. 43 years old, clean mammogram 5 months earlier. I just knew. 4 different doctors told me it was nothing and to come back in a year. I did not, and found a 5th. Yeah, I had to argue my way into being diagnosed with a rare and aggressive form of breast cancer. On the bright side, Thursday was my 5 years all clear date. I was like 8 or 9 when my parents took me and my younger brother to stay the night at my paternal grandparents' house because they were in the middle of divorcing. They lived in a farmhouse that was connected to a barn, with machinery, gasoline tanks, and hay on the ground floor, and furnished rooms on the floor above that. And the room we were supposed to stay in was in that barn. As soon as we went into the guest room, I was overwhelmed by panic and felt really dizzy. I turned around and just said that we will not sleep in that room, and we spent the night on the couch in the living room instead. Later that night, a gas leak in the barn ignited, and almost the entire barn, including the guest rooms on its top floor, exploded. Maybe I had that weird feeling because the gas had leaked into the room already, but no one else felt anything, and I'm sure I would be dead if I hadn't noticed it. Told this one before, but I'll tell it again. I was at a pub party being held for my boyfriend's father, but I had a headache that wasn't going away. I had been drinking, but I wasn't drunk. I was just feeling like crap. So I made my excuses and left to walk home alone, as I didn't want to ruin his night with his dad. It was a 10-minute walk, if that, from the pub to our house, and it wasn't properly dark yet. I walked down the street and passed a man sitting on a wall drinking a beer. A minute after I passed, I heard the bottle smash, and then footsteps a little while back. Nothing unusual, it was a main road and there was another pub further along, but something in my gut was screaming something was wrong. So I hurriedly walked to the pub and stopped outside to ask the smokers for a light and a chat as I smoked. I watched him pass by me and then stare at me from across the street for an uncomfortable amount of time. With my gut screaming at me, I asked a bouncer working the doors if he could order me a taxi. A few weeks later, while in town center, I saw a mugshot of the same dude wanted for rape. When I was around 18, I was on a back road with some friends and a girl I didn't know was driving really fast. Now, I'm a bit of an adrenaline junkie, and I have always enjoyed a calculated risk in the name of a good time. But on this occasion, I told her to either slow the fuck down or let me out. I literally had to start screaming at her before she listened and slowed down. A week later, she crashed on that same stretch of road at 90 miles an hour, killing her and the 3 passengers of her car. I'm a bouncer. Came across a shady individual who had a gun on his person. Asked him to leave the weapon outside in his vehicle, made a huge stink about it, but left it in his car. For some reason, I still felt like it wasn't enough, so I watched him closely all night. He got trashed and then towards closing he decided to get in an argument with some Australian guys. They were all talking about taking the fight outside. One Australian guy already had his shirt off. I asked them to at least take it outside, but I followed closely. Once outside, the guy bent over to tie his shoe, and I realized he had an ankle holster for a second weapon. As he was pulling the gun out, I rushed him, and we fought over the gun. The gun went off and hit a lady in her leg. Finally wrestled the gun out and put him in cuffs with the help of other security. True, a lady got hit that night. But I have a feeling if I hadn't been watching the guy closer, somebody in the Australian group would have died. Is the lady who got hit in the leg didn't stick around for the police. She ran off after getting hit. Might have had a warrant or something, but it didn't seem like a life-threatening shot. Drunk people are weird. I think I was 10 or 11, and I was reorganizing my room, moving books and stuff around. I had been working on it all day, and during the process I moved a bookshelf on top of a dresser to give me more space, and loaded it up with 2 encyclopedia sets and a bunch of other books. I ended up moving my bed parallel to the dresser and passed out from working on my room all day. I woke up a little after 4 and was contemplating getting a glass of water and moving my bed because it didn't look safe under the bookshelf. I finally got out of bed and walked towards the door, maybe 2 to 3 steps and boom, 1994 Northridge earthquake hit. The bookshelf instantly fell on my bed. I didn't know if it would have killed me, but it would have really smashed me up. Went to go catch the bus, saw the bus about to pull out from the stop, and I could have made it if I ran. Something told me not to catch it and just wait for the next one, so I did. Caught the next bus half an hour later. Now, I usually sit at the back of the bus on the driver's side, so that's where I sat. A little way into the journey, traffic was slowing, and we got to the cause of it. A lorry had crashed into the bus I had missed, right into the back on the driver's side. Had I caught that bus, I wouldn't be here. Still gives me chills after 6 years. I was staying at a friend's house out in the country. He was asleep in another room. I was dozing off with his gigantic pit bull, Izzy Bell. Sweet girl. In the middle of the night, I am awoken by sounds outside, like scrabbling. Izzy leaps up too, looks at me, then the back door, and growls. My friend at the time had a younger daughter, 4 or 5, so I immediately think of her. I grab the nearest weapon, which is a fire poker, and go to open the door as Izzy is beside me, seemingly ready for a fight. But it didn't feel right. I instead bar the door best I can and creep to a window looking out. Outside is a gigantic bear, so big it could easily rip my head off, and it has a few cubs in tow. I watch as it ambles off. I'm pretty sure that if I had charged out that door as I originally intended, me and Izzy would not be here today. I was taking my mom to a follow-up appointment from back surgery the month before. The freeway was closed due to a car accident, and Life Flight was canceled to transport the people injured in the accident. The highway patrol was funneling everyone off of the freeway to the right side exit. I had the strongest feeling we needed to move to the left farthest lane, so I did. No more than a minute after I moved over, a garbage truck came barreling down the freeway and crashed into the car that was in front of us in the other lane so fast that it lifted the front end of the truck and it landed on top of the car. We were in a tiny sports car that would have crumpled like a tin can under the weight of a garbage truck and definitely would have killed my mom and me in a second. My mom knew something was wrong with me when I was younger. Doctors didn't want to see me for another 2 weeks. Mom went into a blind rage over the phone, telling them that she was taking me to get checked, whether they liked it or not. We got to the GP. He puts a stethoscope on my back and smells my breath, then says, "We need to get him to the hospital now." Turns out I have type 1 diabetes, and if I'd waited another day, I would have died. A few years ago, I was at a bar with a couple of friends. All was good. We were drinking and having fun. All of a sudden, we heard this discussion taking place just a couple tables from us. Two guys decided to have a shouting/threat match. I stopped everything to pay attention to them. My friends were making fun of me, saying I was gossipy. One of the guys in the discussion got up and left. Immediately after he left, I told my friends we had to go. Now. Let's get the fuck out now. They didn't get why I was like that, but I'm their friend since forever. They reluctantly agreed. We went to a different bar in a different neighborhood, but I couldn't take my mind off of those two guys. The next day, the news were talking about a bar fight. Apparently, the guy who got up went home, grabbed a gun, and came back for a drive-by. Killed 4 people in the process. My grandpa taught me to never ignore my gut, and I couldn't be happier to have listened. A few weeks ago, I had just left my apartment complex and was heading to a friend's. I pulled out of my driveway and up to the traffic light and stopped. I was in the left turn lane, light was red. It was laid out, and there wasn't many people on the road. I watched as the light went yellow and then red for through traffic. One guy ran the tail end of the yellow like usual. My turn. Light goes green, I have an arrow blinking for me to turn left. I looked both ways and there was no one around and I just didn't go. I cannot explain what happened other than something inside me just said, "Don't go." So I sat there staring at the green light. A couple seconds later, a car came screaming through the red light, through the intersection, probably doing 100 kilometers an hour, in the lane I would have been turning into. They were going so fast, their vehicle had a bounce to it. If I had turned, my car would have been destroyed, and me along with it. I sat there through the whole next light cycle and then turned, pulled over, and called my sister. It was a ghostly feeling. I am a light jumper. I look both ways when I am impatient, and I cannot explain what stopped me from going the second that light went green, but I'm glad it did. A pain in the lungs when I inhaled. I've never been stabbed, don't know what it's like, but the pain should have been equal to it, if not worse. It had happened before, years ago. Some hot water in the shower and the pain was gone. My wife, then girlfriend, insisted on going to ER. I insisted on hot water. "I feel like we should go and see a doctor," she had said. I was diagnosed with pulmonary embolism on both lungs. Doctor said, "One or two more hours, and you were gone." So yeah, I owe my wife one. It didn't happen to me, but was told by my mom. When she was pregnant with my older sister, her and her family decided to go hiking in the mountains. On the day of the hike, she suddenly felt discomfort and uncomfortable, so she stayed behind while the rest of her family went for the hike. Her family got lost, and if it wasn't for my mom staying behind, they wouldn't have gotten help. Keep in mind that there was no cell phones back then, so if you got lost, it was a lot harder to contact rescue to come find you. Funny enough, my sister was also born during an earthquake. Different story. My now wife and I did the long distance thing in college, and I planned on doing my normal routine to visit her, leave Chicagoland in the morning, get to her early afternoon on Friday. Well, I'm closing my store on Thursday night, and get a feeling I should leave that night. So I said, "F it," and left that night. A little after lunch on Friday, tornado sirens go off. I don't think anything of it until I head back home Sunday and drive through a town about half hour north of her. It got lit up by the tornado. I quickly realized that had I left at my normal time, I would have been smack dab in the middle of tornado.